Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today I have brought to you a lot of questions. Yes, in this video there are many questions, but all those questions are very relevant for your RBI, SEBI and other banking examinations at the level of BO. I'm not saying NABARD because NABARD examination has recently been conducted by the NABARD organization. So now let's move on to the questions. But before that, if you want to download the PDF of this session, then you have to join our Telegram channel, and the link of that channel is in description below. And before moving on to the first question, I would like to make a request to you all that, guys, if you like the content that we provide to you in the form of various videos that we come up with, then you can just subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification, and also inform your friends about our channel. So on that note, let's begin with our first question. So, which state has topped in the small states category in the Public Affairs Index 2021? So here the right answer is Sikkim. Now, what is this index all about? First of all, you need to understand that the organization which has released this index is not a very eminent organization. Okay, so there are very meager chances that a question would be put up from this news in your RBI or SEBI phase one examination. However, we need to cover such indices because they tell us about the state of affairs in different states of India, and however meager it is, but still, if there is 0.01% possibility is there for this news to come in your examination, then it is your responsibility to cover it thoroughly. Okay, so let's cover this news. Public Affairs Centers, which is a Bangalore based non-profit organization, has released this Public Affairs Index 2021. So basically, before moving into the results, let me tell you that this Public Affairs Index assesses the states of India on the basis of the governance, the quality of the governance of the states. And in governance, it has basically three pillars: equity, growth, and sustainability. These are the three parameters on which the states have been assessed. However, if we want to put it broadly, then this index has assessed the response of the state governments towards the COVID-19 pandemic. How well did they handle that pandemic? And secondly, the thing that was assessed in this index was the implementation of the centrally sponsored schemes. So guys, there are two categories of schemes: central sector and centrally sponsored. In central sector, you have 100% funding from the central government, whereas in centrally sponsored scheme, the scheme is partly funded by the state government. So how well the states are implementing the centrally sponsored schemes within the states, that was also one of the parameters of this index. However, that parameter was clubbed into these three pillars. Okay, so as far as the indicators of this index are concerned, equity, growth, and sustainability are the indicators. Now let's discuss the results. So in the larger states category, Kerala is number one, number two Tamil Nadu, number three Telangana. Small states mein, Sikkim first, Goa second, Mizoram third. In UTs, Puducherry first, Jammu Kashmir second, Chandigarh third. Now the things that I have explained to you about the index, like the COVID-19 response index and the implementation of the central sponsored scheme, all of this is explained in words here. So you can just read it out on your own when you will get the PDF of this session. There is nothing much, believe this in this, I have already explained to you everything. Okay, question number two is, which organization has organized the deep dive online training program during the National Cyber Security Awareness Month? So out of these organizations, National E-Governance Division is the right answer. So this organization is a part of the Ministry of Electronics and IT, and this organization has organized this deep dive training program in order to train the officials, the IT officials of various central and state government departments, banks, or any PSU is there, whichever organization is there which is related to the central government or the state government or run by them. The IT officials of those organizations will be trained under this program, which is being run by National E-Governance Division. I hope that it is clear to you. Now, you need to know that this is being run under the साइबर सुरक्षित भारत इनिशिएटिव, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट इज दैट द नेशनल साइबर सिक्योरिटी अवेयरनेस मंथ इज अक्टूबर, सो डू रिमेंबर दैट इज वेल. Which university is the top ranked university in the Times Higher Education's World University Reputation Ranking 2021? So you know that we have Times, we have QS, we have Shanghai ranking. Shanghai also releases its ranking. So we have different organizations which release their own rankings for the institutions or universities. So this is one of those rankings released by the Times Higher Education institution. Now, which organization has topped in it? So the university is Harvard University. From India, IISc Bangalore has topped. It is in 91-100 ranking band. IIT Bombay is the second. If we talk about only the universities from India, then IIT Delhi and IIT Madras both are in the same group. Now, guys, do pay attention that IISc Bangalore, IIT Bombay and IIT Delhi, all of them have shown a very magnificent improvement. Why I'm saying this? Because IISc Bangalore was earlier in this grouping and now it has jumped into this ranking, and this is basically inside the top 100. So this is one of the achievements of IISc Bangalore. Also, IIT Bombay was ranked way before this band, so it has also jumped into this 126 to 150 ranking, which shows an improvement in its ranking. IIT Delhi has for the first time entered into this list, so also IIT Delhi has shown improvement, and in total we have top four institutions from India in this list, which ranks 202 universities only from 29 countries. Okay, so total four Indian universities are there in this list. Harvard is first, MIT of US is second, and University of Oxford is third. Which organization has released the greenhouse gas bulletin? So here the right answer is World Meteorological Organization, and this report is very important, guys. For your better understanding, I have divided the facts of this report into three segments: the gases, the global warming, and the carbon sink. Okay, so as far as the gases are concerned, so this report has shown how much the greenhouse gases have increased from the pre-industrial level, that is 1750s, to the present times. Okay, so if we talk about the carbon dioxide, then it has increased by 149%. Methane has increased by 262%. Do remember the scientific symbols of these gases. Nitrous oxide has increased by 123%. Global warming from 1990 to 2020. The warming effect on the climate, basically the contribution of greenhouse gases towards the climate change, towards the global warming, has increased by 47%. And out of this 47%, out of the total contribution of the greenhouse gases, the major contribution was by the carbon dioxide, which is 80%. Okay. The next is, the last time when Earth experienced this kind of heat, this kind of drastic increment in the temperature, was the time period which was 3 to 5 million years ago, and at that point of time the temperature was 2 to 3 degrees Celsius and the sea level was 10 to 20 meters higher than now. But of course, the time period that we are looking at here was the time period when there were no humans. At present, we have more than 7 billion humans on the earth. So how are we going to tackle this change? This is something that we need to see in future. Okay, so before moving on to the next point from this report, let me tell you guys the reports that are from the international organizations or that are related to the climate. Do cover them thoroughly, because you can expect a question in your descriptive as well on the impact of climate change on economy, okay, or how the climate change is impacting the least developed economies. For example, we have covered a report on the deglaciation of Africa in some days back, in one of the videos some days back. Okay, so such kinds of reports are important, so cover these reports very thoroughly. The next point here is carbon sink. So the ocean and land ecosystem can absorb only half of the carbon that is released into the environment, and half of the carbon, total carbon released, remains in the environment. That leads to the increment in the global temperature. So that is very basic point. How many new members have been added into the reconstituted Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister? So the three members have been added into the council right now, and the total number of members are 7. The chairperson is Vivek Debroy. So he was earlier the chairperson, now he is continuing his position. New members are Rakesh Mohan, P.T. Ram Mohan, and Poonam Gupta. So they are the holders of very prominent positions. He was the former RBI deputy governor. T.T. Ram Mohan is the IIM Ahmedabad professor. Poonam Gupta is the director general of NCAER. Important hai, do remember. Other members of this council are Sajid Chinoy, Neelkant Mishra, and Nilesh Shah. The basic purpose of this council is to advise the Prime Minister on the economic situation of the country. So that is the very basic purpose of this council. Do remember the composition of this council, because it has been reconstituted now. What is the name of the app launched by the Election Commission of India for digital mapping of all polling booths by adding latitude and longitude by booth level officers? Garud Vishti, Chunav, Komari, and Varuna. So these are the options, out of which Garud is the right answer. Election Commission of India has launched this application, and on this application, every information related to the polling booth, also the information related to the voters, like their names, and if the booth level officers want to delete some voters from that list because these voters have died or they have shifted to other countries, or if any such circumstance arise, then the deletion of the voters from the voting list, the addition of the voters who have become eligible to vote, or the change in their address, all of these activities can now be done online on this application. Apart from this, facilities on the polling booth, the toilets, the water, sanitation, such basic facilities, information is also provided on this platform. Okay, so this is the application that has been launched. Okay guys, before moving on to this question, let me ask you one question. Recently, the Chief Election Commissioner of India has visited Uzbekistan in order to preside over the elections of Uzbekistan's president. You have to name both the eminent personalities here. First is India's Chief Election Commissioner, and second is Uzbekistan's president. Name both of them in the comment section below. Let's see how active you are in your current affairs and general awareness. Which has become the first state to release its own wildlife action plan? Here the right answer is Maharashtra, and there is nothing much from this news that you need to know. Okay, just remember this thing that Maharashtra is the first state. Which country has been recently excluded from the African Union? So here the right answer is Sudan. Now it has been excluded because of the recent military coup that happened in this country. The questions that are arising from this news are very interesting for you all to know. Okay, so the very first from the basics, African Union Mission, you can expect a question. For example, the headquarters, Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. This was a question in your RBI Grade B examination 2019 phase 1. Where is the headquarters of African Union? That was a question, guys. Total number of members, because this is the exclusion of a member, so you can very well expect this question in your examination. Excluding Sudan, 54 members are there. Chair. Now this name, if you don't even remember this name, then it would be fine, because in my perspective, they are not going to ask you about the name of the chair of this African Union. However, the country can become a question. Okay, so do remember, for this tenure, this country is the chair of African Union. Now, the questions that can be framed from Sudan itself. So, I think from geography, they can ask you some questions like, which sea surrounds the country Sudan, Dead Sea, okay, not surrounds but touches the border of Sudan. Which Gulf, Sudan is near to which Gulf? So it is Gulf of Aden, okay. Now this is the Horn of Africa, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Djibouti and Somalia. However, I don't think that they can ask you such question, but still if they ask you this question that which countries are the bound land border, are the countries that share the land borders with Sudan, then you should also be aware of the fact that these are the countries that share the border with Sudan, okay. And these are the countries that are a part of the Horn of Africa. So all of this is clear, and this is our India. Arabian Sea is there. Okay, so I think I have covered everything from this news. Moving on to the next question. Which company has launched the AppScale Academy program to train early to mid-stage startups across India on building high-quality app for the world? So here the right answer is Google. Do remember this news, guys. AppScale Academy initiative has been launched by partnering with the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Okay, and under this program, basically, the local startups will get access to guidance, to mentorship by Google to develop applications around gaming, healthcare, financial technology, education, social impact domains, etc. And in this program, a total of 100 startups will be selected, and the focus will be on the emerging startups in tier 2 and tier 3 cities of India. Okay. So here the session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the session. And guys, if you have really enjoyed the session, then do not forget to like this video, share it among your friends. Thank you so much.